naked issue. Mm-hmm. And, you know, this year social media went wild with the hype around certain celebrities.
I know.
Which is all very exciting for us, because the reason we do the naked issue is we believe that as South Africans, we suffer from basic charity overkill. Mm-hmm. I mean, you're driving down the road and the first person you see is somebody asking for money.
Yeah.
On every street corner. And I think because people feel that way, you need something that's going to cut through the noise. Mm-hmm. And because Marie Claire is about fashion and with the heart, we choose a charity that really moves us every year. And then we approach the wonderful celebrities and ask them to please help
you out.
But bearing it all, but being incredibly brave, essentially.
Absolutely. You say that it's been in season, of course, for 8 years now.
Yes.
How has it grown throughout those 8 years?
Well, I think the first year was before my time, but in my 4 years that I've edited the magazine, it's become a work of art. And I think when you look at the pictures this year, they're incredibly beautiful. We had an amazing photographer, Mavelian van der Merwe, and a wonderful producer, and together they created a very beautiful setting.
Yeah.
So that it's about aesthetics. It's about the beauty of the human form versus something that's sexual or
all right, let's talk about
worrying.
The stars now. Let's put you on hold for a moment. Let's talk about the ladies. Welcome, ladies. I'll start with Petronella. When you received the phone call to come perform a nude photo shoot, what's the first thing that went through your mind, and why did you decide yes?
I mean, for me, this is not the first time I've actually done nude. I mean, I did nude in my film of Good Report. So for me, it gave me... it's motivated me more than anything. I'm a mother, so I have imperfections. So what it did is actually...
Not that you can see them, sorry.
You always say this and we're like, what?
No, and the thing is, it's confidence as well. Mm-hmm. So for me doing this and going nude wasn't because, oh, I think I'm fit or I'm strong. Mm. For me, it is the message that I'm sending across. So me being a mother, it's, would I send my child to school without food? And for me, it's like, it's so important, education and nutrition. So for me, it only made sense. So obviously when I got the call, I was very excited. And so I hope we've gotten the message across, and I hope we can continue building the Lunchbox Fund.
And Nomuzi, do you share the same sentiments, or do you feel that at times people miss the point and focus on the naked picture instead of the message you're trying to assist in getting across?
I think anybody that was on Twitter this week saw that some people really did miss the message, but at the end of the day, people saw us in the nude and they were like, wow, Boysie is nude. Why? Because she was doing this for the Marie Claire nude issue. Why? Because they're trying to feed these hungry school children. So eventually it did come to the point of what it was all about. Yeah. But I mean, especially for us, it's an honor to be in the Marie Claire naked issue. They don't just pick anybody. They pick people with relevance and talkability. Mm. So for us, it was a huge honor to do the shoot. And if people saw it and they saw us naked, it's great. But I mean, it really did help 4 million children. And that was the point at the end of the day. So whether you think of it as just a bunch of celebrities getting naked, or you see what it's really about, at the end of the day, 4 million children were fed. Yeah. And it forced us to have a conversation. Like, why were there 4 million children that weren't fed anyway?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it forces us to have conversations about nudity and about the poverty in our country. So it's a very important issue. So whether people get it or not, it's a conversation that we do need to have.
Now let's talk about those 4 million children, Espasia. Specifically because in my understanding, what tweeters had to do, or tweets had to do, is they had to buy the issue, they had to take a picture of their issue and then hashtag it, right?
Precisely.
And that would, of course, raise funds. Why
we
that
are
method?
Do that afterwards.
Yeah, and why that method, and why
so
the Lunchbox Fund?
The Lunchbox Fund, the way it came about, I was at a conference hosted by Grace and Michelle, and I met a young woman, completely gorgeous, I might add. She's a model. Her name is Topaz Page Green, and she'd moved to New York to model about 10 years ago. And essentially, she was visiting South Africa and had gone to a school in Soweto to see with her former teacher, who was doing an outreach program there. And it was lunchtime, and she saw that the children were sitting in two groups. There was one group that was eating its lunch, and there was another group that was facing away. And she said, why are these kids facing away? What's going on here? And the teacher said, well, there are two things. The children are embarrassed because they don't have lunch. And they don't want to see the children eating lunch because it makes them more hungry. And I thought, well, my goodness, that is the most tragic thing I've heard. So it brought me to tears. But what it did with Topaz is that she started the Lunchbox Fund, and she started it in New York, which and you know has an amazing array of celebrities who've bought into it. Also, there's a new Feedy app where you can take a picture of the food you're eating, buying into this whole like sort of crazy Instagram tweeting
selfie
of food.
Yes.
Yeah, and then. It goes, if the scheme belongs to Feedy, then it buys a meal for a child. And so we thought, well, using that system, let's have a picture of the Marie Claire with the cover, take a selfie, hashtag it MC Naked, and we as the magazine will buy a meal a day. And it's been amazing because we've had a lot of response, and we're hoping that more people will do it.
Now let's get into some of the criticism. I mean, I see the good that is coming out of the organization, but I'm sure you've received numerous criticism about the naked issue. Some have asked, do you really have to go naked for this? If you're a celebrity, can't you open an organization, just canvas, campaign, the usual route that celebrities, of course, take. Did you have to go naked for this issue to raise funds? Petronella?
For me, yes. It's out there. It's in your face, and it makes you want to actually pick up the magazine. The thing is, that's the problem in our continent. We in South Africa, we still like backwards, unfortunately. This thing of being nude. If you see my picture, for example, I'm only showing a breast. I mean, I think that's beautiful. Do you understand? I think my body is an art, and I use my body in whatever form I can. Yeah. So for me, yes, going nude, it makes you pay attention. It makes you pick up that magazine. And for me, it was very classically stylized and beautifully, you know, captured.
And there are a bit of contradictions there, because if you remember recently with the whole red carpet with the Sona, there was a lady who was a member of parliament who was criticized, saying, oh my goodness, can she cover up? And then there are beautiful ladies, so you would assume, and they're like, no, 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 cover up. So it seems like there was mixed reactions with regards to Twitter going about, and those different two ladies, of course, coming from two different generations, I would assume. What do you think that says, or how does it reflect on society as far as watching a naked woman?
You know, I mean, this lady was on the red carpet at the States of the Nation address. She wasn't there by mistake. She's an important person.
Yes.
And for us to be in this magazine, we're important people who are doing something really great. I saw something on Instagram yesterday that said, people will see you walk on water and they'll say it's because you can't swim. So I mean, you really aren't going to please anybody. So a lot of people are like, this isn't even the best one that they've had. Well, it's the only one that I've done, and I think it's beautiful. So and the children are fed. I think, like, hello, everybody, we're feeding children at the end of the day. That's the point of this whole magazine. So I mean, you're not going to please everybody. And we were just doing our parts in the way that we could, and we forced you guys to have a conversation that you didn't want to have. And as artists, that's essentially what we want to do. We want to get you guys talking, whether it's good or bad. You saw it. And we were in it, and for that second, we were on your mind. So, I mean, it did something. It caused
it
a conversation.
It definitely provoked a whole lot of thought and conversations.
Yeah. I think that's what's difficult. As I said before, I think there's charity overkill. People are almost bored and they switch off. And they don't want to. I think it's so easy. And especially with regard to the lady from Sonar. And if you think about how quick everything is on Instagram and social media, it rushes through. Today, your flavor of the month. Tomorrow, we're over you. The thing is, how do you cut through the noise and make an impact?
Absolutely.
And I think that was what we've achieved.
Thank you so much
to these beautiful girls.
You couldn't have done it without them, right?
Not
you did.
At all.
Wow, congratulations.
They're
thank
so
you
brave.
So much for your time, ladies. Editor, of course, Marie Claire Aspasia Karas, and of course, actress Petronella Tsuma, hope I pronounced it correctly, and TV presenter Nomuzi Mabena. Thank you so much. It's lovely hosting you.
Thank you.